This segment is sponsored by KidMed Pediatric Urgent Care.
The doctor is in and you have questions. Today, I'm joined by Dr. Mark Flazenbaum of KidMed Pediatric Urgent Care. We're talking about a number of topics, including how COVID-19 impacts children. It's great to see you, doctor.
Hi, Jessica. Nice to see you, too.
I want to start right off the top. The big question we have for you is, let's talk about KidMed Pediatric Urgent Care. You had an interesting situation just the other day where somebody wasn't fully aware of everything that you do there.
Yes, it came up. We are seeing up to 25 through age 25 now. And I think the word has gotten out there that we'll do COVID testing. And I had an interesting situation where a young lady in her 20s came in for COVID testing. And while she was getting tested for that, she mentioned that she injured her finger at the gym that she works at and wanted to know where she can go to get x-rays done. And I had to tell her, hey, we could do that right here. And she just didn't know that that's what we do. So yeah, for everybody within the age group from newborn all the way up through 25, we do everything across the board for every patient. That includes x-rays, sports injuries, laceration repair, illness, pretty much all the things that we talk about we do for the younger kids, we'll do for everybody.
It's great to know as a one-stop resource for those. And of course, I know we've talked before, Mark, about the things that you handle there. And then if it needs to go elsewhere, you will work with the patient to make sure that they are headed in that right direction. Let's talk a little bit about the COVID-19 impact in children that you're seeing.
Most of the younger kids are fairly asymptomatic, maybe a little bit of runny nose congestion. The vast majority of kids that are COVID positive that we've seen have had a known exposure at daycare or at school, but the younger kids are definitely less symptomatic now. As you get into the older teens and the young adults, we're seeing more of loss of taste or smell, some shortness of breath, vague chest pain, not seeing much in the way of severe illness, but there's always the risk of that. There is a condition, MISC, which is just an inflammatory condition that can show up, and we're very vigilant when looking out for that. But the vast majority of kids and young adults have had fairly mild illness.
Focused on kids up through age 25. And I want to ask you something, Mark. We have about 2 minutes left. One of the ways that you're meeting the needs is through telemedicine. And this can be especially helpful for the college age students.
Yeah, the nice thing, Jessica, about telemedicine is the visit is rather quick. They do it from home. We're even doing telemedicine patients who drive up and say, hey, I'd rather not come in the building, and we can do it that way. But they meet with a provider, a nurse practitioner or a physician, get a history about what's being done, and then someone will come out to the car and do the appropriate swabs, whether it's just the COVID test or checking for flu or strep. And the feedback has been fantastic, that people really like that. They like being able to not have to come in and expose themselves to others, and they like the convenience. They get the test results back within an hour or two. We send them letters for their employers or for the school if they need to. So it seems to be a very smooth functioning system we have.
Meeting the needs of patients. You know, you mentioned the young lady with the broken finger. Mark, let's talk a little bit about how KidMed Pediatric Urgent Care treats injuries and concussions.
The interesting with that, Jessica, is just in the sense that when we have injuries in kids, most people don't realize that how they present is very different than adults, especially with bony injuries, sports injuries. The bones have various growth plates that close at different times. We're all very aware of how those show up on x-ray. And if you don't have training in pediatrics, it's very easy to overcall injuries. And then there are other fractures that don't show up as we typically see them and have just signs where there's fluid next to the bone. You don't actually see a crack in the bone, but it represents a fracture in there. So we're really proud of our group at being able to recognize those kind of injuries that are different in kids than you would see in adults. With regard to concussions, same thing. The old way thinking, the ER way years ago used to be everyone who hit their head and had a headache got CAT scanned. And really, we stay away from that entirely. The vast majority of kids now with head injuries, the recognizing concussion versus minor head injury is so vastly important. because it dictates what kids can do. And the trend now is to have a stepwise approach to returning to sports. We use a lot of consultants, refer a lot of people to sheltering arms and other head injury places for follow-up, such that kids can get back into playing safely, but by stepwise guidelines. It's not no longer a knee-jerk response of take a week off and then get back into sports. It's a very, very stepwise approach that is built in science, and it works well to get kids back safely and quickly.
Important to know. And Doctor, we're out of time, but I do want to mention KidMed Pediatric Urgent Care is offering COVID testing now in small groups for 20 or more. And you're also offering the caregiver test.
Right. We decided we have a lot of caregivers, parents, grandparents who come to the kids who say, can I get tested? And we're lucky enough to have enough supply of our rapid tests to do that. So for the caregivers, it's any caregiver who is present with the child or who can show up before the end of that same day, not the next day, not a week later, that we're willing to test them. They don't get a visit. It's strictly just for the testing. If they have a positive test, we recommend that they talk to their primary care doctor about what to do about that. For the large group, there's a lot of camps, a lot of people who are having weddings, other social events that have approached us. And we thought, you know, it's a good thing to do. So we're arranging for groups of 20 or more. We'll go out to their site and test them as a group. In fact, we're doing a wedding group coming up the next couple of months and a couple of camp groups. And they can contact us at marketing@kidmedva.com. And get in touch with Kathy Green, who's our marketing director, to get that set up.
Excellent. Dr. Mark Flazenbaum, thank you so much for making time. We're going to share some information.
All right. Thank you, Jessica. Much appreciated.
Appreciate you very much. KidMed Pediatric Urgent Care has locations in the West End, Southside, and Mechanicsville. For all the information, visit kidmedva.com. Stay right here with us. We'll be back with more Virginia This Morning after this break.